A warm and pleasant good morning to everyone. This is Tanya Chandna from Honest Chemistry 2nd Sam. Today, I am going to discuss the topic of acidic nature of phenol. Before discussing the acidic nature, we must be aware about the structure of phenol. The structure of phenol is as. Now, the structure of phenol is as because in the benzene ring, the structure of phenol is formed when from the benzene ring, a hydrogen ion is replaced. This hydrogen ion will be replaced by the hydroxide ion. The hydrogen ion is replaced by the hydroxide ion from any other reagent. This can be from any reagent. Then the phenol gets formed, and then we will get this structure and plus hydroxide. From the hydroxide, the ion gets attached here, and the hydronium ion, or we can say the proton, or it can be H3O positive when we are taking the example of water. It is as. And now, if we are discussing about the acidic nature, means we are discussing the removal of this H positive atom from the phenol ring. Now, the acidic nature of phenol is due to the resonance stabilization of the phenoxide ion formed by the removal of the hydroxide ion. Let's see the resonance. First of all, we will see the resonance of the phenol. Here is the phenol. Here is the structure of phenol. Now, the oxygen atom is having the lone pairs, and it will donate its lone pair to the benzene ring as. So, the next resonating structure will be there will be the double bond on the oxygen and a positive charge. It is the main thing that in this kind of resonance, the oxygen atom is having a positive charge. Now, in the next step, it will go inside and this bond will come at this position. The next resonating structure will be here will be the negative charge, here will be the double bond oxygen and hydrogen and the positive charge. Here are the two bonds. The resonance will be in this way. If we will draw the resonance hybrid structure of these structures, then it will be somehow as. Means the oxygen atom in this case, in the case of phenol, we have taken the phenol. In the case of phenol, the oxygen atom is having a partial positive charge on it, and as we know, phenol oxygen atom is highly electronegative. So in case of phenol, it easily leaves down the H positive ion and shows its acidic nature. Now, before discussing the further acidic nature, we will see the resonance of the phenoxide ion formed after the removal of H positive ion. Now, as it is phenol, from phenol, the H positive ion gets removed. Here it will be O negative, and it will form the phenol, will form the phenoxide ion. The phenol will form the phenoxide ion. And now the phenoxide ion, when we will see the resonance in the phenoxide ion, we will found, let's see its resonance, and it will be as. In the next picture, it will be as. here will be the bone get shifted, and here will be the negative charge. Here is double bond oxygen. Now if we will see the resonance hybrid structure, we will find that in the resonating hybrid structure, we will find that in the resonating hybrid structure of the phenoxide ion, we will have a partial negative charge on the oxygen atom. But as we have discussed earlier, in case of phenol, the phenol is having the partial positive charge on the oxygen atom, but in the case of phenoxide ion, it is having a partial negative charge. So this is the reason because of which the phenol easily leaves the H positive ion in any solution or by attacking of the any reagent. So a lot of groups attached to the phenol, and these groups can be categorized as electron withdrawing group as well as electron donating group. Now, what is the structure of phenol? And on these position, these two positions which I have mentioned as one are the ortho positions. These two positions which I have mentioned as two are meta positions. And this position is para position. And this position is somehow also named as epso. So if any group is attached to either ortho, meta or para position, it will affect the acidic nature of the phenol. It can either increase the acidic nature or decrease the acidic nature. It will be dependent on the type of reagent attacking to it. Now it can be an electron donating group as well as electron withdrawing group. Now the question arises, which group will be considered as electron donating group and which group will be considered as electron withdrawing group? So we will decide it on the basis of the electronegativity difference. Electronegativity difference with respect to the carbon atom. As we are discussing the hydrocarbon derivative of the benzene, means we are discussing about the carbon and hydrogen. So, and we will discuss the electronegativity difference with respect to carbon. And the first case is when, if the electronegativity difference of the attacking reagent electronegativity difference is greater than the carbon, then it will be considered as the electron withdrawing. But if the second case is if the electronegativity difference of the attacking reagent will be less. In some cases, the electronegativity difference is also equal than the electronegativity of carbons, means it is approximately very less, or it in some point values or something else. So then that group will be considered as electron donating group. Let us see some examples of electron donating group as well as electron withdrawing group. As we know, the electronegativity of the carbon is less than that of nitrogen. So the compound having the nitrogen atom will be electron withdrawing group. Let us take an example which will clear it more. This is an example of nitrophenol, and in this case the NO2 group that will act as an electron withdrawing group, and as it is an electron withdrawing group, it will show some effects, like it will show minus I effect, it will show minus R effect, show minus I effect and minus R effect. It is electron withdrawing group, and now it can not only attach to this meta position, and this it can be attached to ortho positions as well as on para position and as well as on the other meta positions. It will affect in different way. If it is present on the ortho position, it will affect the acidic nature of phenol in a different way. Let us see how. when the electron withdrawing group is attached in, we are taking the case of the ortho nitrophenol. In this case, it will form the intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Because of this, and due to this, the acidic nature of the ortho nitrophenol will decrease in comparison to that of paranitrophenol. In case of paranitrophenol, there will no intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So the acidic nature of paranitrophenol will be the highest. Paranitrophenol will be the most highest, and then after that, the acidic nature order will be as ortho nitrophenol, and then it will be meta nitrophenol, and then the single phenol. The reason for this order is very simple. As in case of ortho nitrophenol, there will be intramolecular hydrogen bonding, due to which the acidic nature will get decreased. But in case of meta nitrophenol, there will be no intramolecular hydrogen bonding. But as we know, at meta position, resonance will not work. So there will be only minus I effect on that position. Only minus I effect will work. In this case, both minus I as well as minus R effect will work. Here in this case, due to intramolecular hydrogen bonding, the acidic nature gets decreased. But in case of meta nitrophenol, there will be no intramolecular hydrogen bonding, but minus R effect will not work. Only minus I effect will work. And in case of phenol, there will be no extra effect. So in short, we can conclude that it is, however, can increase as well as decrease. As in case of ortho nitrophenol, it is only increasing. In case of electron withdrawing group, the acidic nature is increasing due to the presence of the extra group, or the attacking group, as we can say, NO2 group. Now, as the number of NO2 group will increase, the acidic nature will also increase. As the number of NO2 group will increase, the acidic nature will also increase. Like we see the example in which we are having NO2 group at 3 positions. And in other we are having the NO2 groups at 2 positions. Here and here. And in third case, we will see that we are having NO2 group only at a single position. So if we will consider the acidic nature, then the acidic nature of picric acid, in which we are having the NO2 groups at 3 positions, there is a picric acid. So it will having the highest acidic nature due to the presence of more electron withdrawing groups. Due to this presence, it will having the highest acidic nature. So it was about the effect of electron withdrawing group. Now we will see the effect of electron donating group. Electron donating groups like methyl gets attached. In case we are taking the example of electron donating group like CH3, that is methyl, is attached. It is an electron donating group. It is known as crisol. And in this case also, the electron donating groups can be attached to ortho position as well as meta position as well as para position. But in this case, what is the factors which will play a crucial role are plus I effect as well as the second effect will be the hyperconjugation. hyperconjugation the same. And hyperconjugation, as we know, also does not work at metaposition. Now, as plus I effect will increase the electron density on this electron density on this bond. As it will play positive I effect, it will increase the electron density. The plus I effect as well as the plus means the hyperconjugation effect, both will increase the electron density on this phenol. So due to this increase in the electron density, the acidic nature will decrease. So the order will be as, the order of acidic nature when various groups are attached will be as, phenol will be the most acidic, then after that metacrysol, and then paracrysol, and at last it will be orthocrysol. Now the reason behind this is that in case of phenol, there will be no other atom attached which increase the electron density. So the bond will get break easily and H positive will get released out. In case of metacrysol, means the CH3 is attached here. In this case, the hyperconjugation. Hyperconjugation will not work. So in this case, as hyperconjugation will not work, only plus I effect will increase the electron density. That's why it is more acidic than para and ortho. And now if we will see that it is on para position, hyperconjugation will work as well as plus I effect will work. But as we know, the plus I effect will decrease with the increase in the length. Due to increase in length, that's why the paracrysol is more acidic in comparison to orthocrysol. And in case of orthocrysol, both effects will work with a high rate. That's why it is having the least acidic character. So it was all about the acidic nature of phenol. Thank you so much, everyone.